Python Pop, a series of quick videos explaining different Python functions and commands. And in today's video, we're actually going to code the cross product. Now, if you don't remember exactly what the cross product is, I'll leave a link in the video description below taking you to one of my tutorial videos. But basically, the cross product takes two vectors and finds a third vector that is orthogonal to both of those vectors. So, for example, if we have some vector u, let's make that 2, 3, 1. So I, J, K, or X, Y, Z, however you want to think about it. We have some vector u, and we'll do some vector v. Let's make this one 0, 5, and then 4. So if we were to find the cross product between u and v, that would be one vector that's orthogonal to both. Negate that vector, or take the opposite of it, and we'd get v cross u. But let's just do u cross v for now. So we're going to go ahead and write a function for this. And we'll name that function appropriately, the cross product. We're going to take in vector u, and we're going to take in vector v. And if we want to return a vector, that's going to be another list or some other array that also has three components. Remember the dot product in a previous video returned a scalar. A cross product is returning a vector. So if our vector is going to be some vector q, we'll be returning q. But q has three different components itself. It has an I component or an x component, so we'll name that qi. It has a j component, so that will be qj. And it has a k component, qk. Now I'm going to write the formulas for those quickly, but we're saying that q is going to be equal to each of those, qi, comma, qj, comma, qk. So for qi, remember when solving for the I component, we're going to use the j and k components of our u and v vector. So it's going to be the second component of u, which is u1, and that's going to be multiplied by the third component of v, so that's v2, and we're subtracting, just switch those numbers within the index around. So we're now going to do u2 times v1. Now, just to make this quicker, let's go ahead and copy this, except now, as opposed to 1 and 2, for our q sub j, we need to start by taking the third component of u, so that's the k component, which is that 2, and multiply that by the first component of v, 0. And now, let's just switch those up. U 0 times v 2. Essentially, we're finding the determinant of all these mini matrices within this cross product. And last but not least, we're going to do q sub k, the third component of our q vector, which is going to be the first component of u times the second component of v minus that other diagonal. So u 0 times v1, and then switch it, minus u1 times v0. And this should return q for us. So let's go ahead, run this formula with our u and v vector that we've previously defined. And there we get it, 7, negative 8, 10, which is indeed the cross product of u and v. And one quick note, a way to double check this is to go ahead and do a 3D graph, which I'll show you in another Python Pop video. But for now, let's just use NumPy to help us double check. In NumPy, there's already commands for doing the cross product. So let's go ahead and import that, and then we can type np.cross our two vectors, u and v, run it, and we do indeed get 7, negative 8, 10, just in an array format, whereas this was a list because we've never converted it to an array. So hopefully, by doing some of these Python Pop videos, you're getting more comfortable with writing formulas and turning those into functions. That wraps up this video. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.